Or I see things the same way as you. Might as well.
Well, maybe I don't see things clearly yet. That's why things are going to take some time. But I appreciate your concern. So, do you want a quick handy, or...
Mood breaker!
You are possibly the most open elf I've ever met. It's very discomforting at times.
I don't have claws yet, come on! You better get them while the getting's good.
Dear Lord. Awful.
Gother kind of pats Catlin on the shoulder and walks away.
We had that tender moment and it gets ruined with hand jobs. Hand jobs ruin everything.
Okay, if you follow the road to Sharn's Pass, then follow the road across, it'll take you 7 days by foot to get to where you think the glass road is. If you cut across the fields, it'll take you 4 days.
Let's cut across the fields. I mean, we can avoid the glass road.
Yeah, we're okay running through forest. I think fields will be fine.
Okay, sleeping or going straight through?
4 days. We'll have to rest.
Yeah, sleep, yeah.
Alright. So you guys ready to go then, or?
Yep.
Alright, you travel through the fields, and you notice that at night, before Firefall, at least, starts, that Catlin seems to glow with strange bluish aura. It seems as if, that the closer you get to, this destination, the brighter she tends to glow. And the closer you get each day, the bluish color becomes brighter, to the point where you don't even need to start a fire on the final night of your journey.
I glow like a fucking beacon?
Yeah, pretty much.
That's actually really not good when we're trying to remain incognito.
No, it's not. It's horrible. As you get closer to the glass roads, I already mentioned that, I'm sorry. So then, you keep glowing even brighter now, no. On the final day of your journey, you finally reach the glass road, and you notice that it's not exactly glass so much as it looks to be a very kind of almost reflective obsidian. As you step towards it, it just seems darker and darker the closer you come towards it. And you're sort of there. I'll show you on the map. If you guys want to switch your game over to the map, the overworld map.
Okay.
That's where we were. Yeah.
You guys are right around there.
Okay.
Yeah, so you're about, I'd say, maybe a good 100, 150 feet away from the glass road.
Alright, I'm going to pull out my spyglass. Can I spot anyone over there?
It's barren. You look around, but it really does seem pretty barren. You notice something interesting, though. The fields around you, they seem to be lush with green and life. But the fields around the glass road, they seem to be turning to sand and desert. Certainly not something you want you'd expect from meadows to turn into.
Does it continue on for a while, or does it eventually go back to kind of green meadows?
You notice that it continues on for a little bit outwards from the glass road, but then it eventually turns back into meadow.
So it's just the immediate area around the glass road.
How far away are we from Holman Falls at this point?
You are, I believe, a day out. On
okay.
Foot.
Okay.
Well, let's see if we can find out what the deal is with this road and how it extends while there's no one around. And then head on into Holman Falls after that.
Right.
Okay, so what are you guys going to try and do?
I think approaching the road carefully at first and see if we can notice anything visually with how it moves or grows. Or
well, do you want me to see if I can spot from the sky to see if I can spot anything hiding?
Might be a good idea.
I think by this point, am I more adjusted to my wings that I can actually maintain flight?
You can maintain it, yeah.
Alright, well, I'll try to fly above and see if I can't find anything.
Alrighty. Looking from the sky and above, even using your spyglass while in the air, you notice that there's just nothing around. It just seems dead quiet.
I'll return to the group and tell them that I don't see anything waiting for us, so might be worth it to get this chance to investigate while we have a moment.
Has there ever been any information about what happens if someone steps on the glass road itself?
You've not received any information regarding to that.
Get like a gerbil and throw a
gerbil. You can sacrifice a gerbil to it.
What? Hey, this. Canaries!
Where are you getting gerbils from?
He does have a gimp with him now. But no, Dothar, Denora, perhaps you might want to investigate this.
Investigate the glass road.
Yeah. See if we can't find out how it.
All right. Are you going to investigate the glass road, Dothar?
Yeah. Let me.
Go ahead. Roll an Arcana check.
Yeah. I figure. Okay. That one. Okay. Oh, I selected the wrong one. Whatever. We're all be the same. 17.
You're not sure what's up with the glass road, but as you approach, you get a chill down your spine, and almost every ounce of your being is telling you not to step on this road.
Yeah, let's not follow this road.
Well, not step directly on it, at the very least.
I mean, I'm going to head back just a step. Or back to where the grass is growing. I'm going to grab some grass and I'm going to try dropping it on the road.
You grab some grass and drop it on the road. As it touches the road, it turns to sand, then it gets engulfed in flames and disappears into destruction.
Well, try putting your face on it.
No!
Okay.
You do notice, though, that as you, Kathleen, walk closer to the glass road, it appears that the road returns to normal as you step near it.
Hmm.
What?
When you step near it, it looks like it's returned to normal, but when you step away, the glass returns.
Does my hand glow at all?
Yeah, your hand is glowing.
I'm not going to touch the road, but I'm going to put my hand closer to it.
The closer you get to the road, the more of the road seems to fade away and return the land to its normal look.
Chase that road.
But as you pull away, it returns to the glass road.
So at the very least, you have some sort of safe passage, it seems, Kathleen.
Oh, man. I wonder, I'm tempted to try touching it. Now, do I get any sort of feeling off of this? Does it feel like a dark magic, or does it feel like a magic?
Oh, this is the same dark magic that we explained earlier in the campaign. The closer you get to it, the more overbearing it becomes, as if you're trying to breathe in like a really thick fog or a really thick haze. If you get thicker into it, it'll be really hard to really do anything, and you know, I'll be making you make endurance checks.
Okay. Well, I won't touch it now, but it's strange that it reacts to it. Bahamut?
That's the most likely explanation, to say the least, but...
Well, it's a lot to... something out to think about down the line. Well, we don't have to touch the road, and there's no one around, so let's head and see if we can't get to Holman Falls.
Quite. I guess we'll have to try to follow along the road, but not be near it.
We can travel along the side. We don't have to.
Right. Exactly.
You're going to travel through the sand, or you're going to travel through the meadow?
The meadow.
Okay. It's going to take about a day to do that. You travel along the meadow near the sand, and Kathleen, you notice that when you travel near the sand, it returns to a meadow-like state, only to return to sand as you depart from it. Traveling along towards Holman Falls, the closer you get to Holman Falls, the more the sand starts to sort of envelop you. Finally, you sort of lose all meadow, and you're just the only meadow that is left is what's behind you, and the path to Holman Falls is covered in sand.
Does my presence still change the land where I am?
Yeah, It's still where you are, in the immediate area around you, it does.
Okay. How far away from Holman Falls are we?
You'd estimate you're about a half day out.
If I use my spyglass, can I see anything on the road or,
On the road from here? No, it's pretty much the same quiet desolation that you've noticed before.
Alright. Well, let's head towards Holman Falls, then.
Sounds like as good of a plan as anything.
Alright, now I need you to specifically tell me how you're going to travel there.
I'm going to stand as close to Caitlin as I can.
Well,
thank you.
Right. You guys going to walk in, like, a circle around her? Just, like, all scared, like, save us, Jesus.
Well, I'm...
I want to try to go in first, try to get as much daylight in as we can, rest before we get there. I don't want to go in at night, but I want to, you know, be examining what I can see from Holman Falls every few moments, or, you know, every few hours or so.
It would be, now thinking about it, would be interesting if there's any way to get into the docks at Holman Falls, if there are any there, but we don't have any means of getting, we don't have any sort of boat or anything to get there on, so.
No, I think the best way is just to approach it directly, so.
Yeah.
That's,
So I guess you guys are going to walk through the sand as if you're, like, clinging to Kathleen, almost.
Near enough.
Now I get to be the one to lead you guys.
Yeah.
Nobody grab my ass.
They can't. Your tail's in the way.
Oh.
You walk through the sand or the meadow that the
Let me aura touch my tail.
That the aura around Kathleen sort of generates. And you're about, you feel you're pretty close to Holman Falls, you can see it in the distance, and when you pull out your spyglass to look at it, Kathleen, it looks as if Holman Falls has been through one hell of a war. It looks like, the building, there are buildings, but they're in no condition to hold any sort of life. There are walls that are torn down, there was a church that you can no longer make out what church they worshipped at, what god they worshipped at that church. There's land there that is burnt to the ground. There's a lot of what you see is death and desolation and nastiness.
All right. Well, can I smell anything in that direction? Do I smell any humans or?
You don't smell humans, but you smell something you've never sort of smelled before, and it does not smell good to you. It smells almost it's wretched. Almost makes you want to sort of puke every time you really pay attention to it. It's not death, either. It's not, like, rotting bodies or anything.
Yeah, I know. I'm pretty sure I know what that is, but... Alright, well, we have to get in there. There might still be people left, and I just can't smell them. So much presence of everything else there. Investigate the numbers.
What'd you say?
Let's at least investigate the numbers of what's ever in Holman Falls.
Okay.
So is it morning, or...?
It's almost nighttime.
Right, well, we're going to rest the night, then.
Okay, so you guys all cuddle up around Kathleen for the night. Afraid of the sand around you.
This is awkward.
This is like you're all in like this one fucking area around Kathleen, like, oh, save us. Save us, Jesus Dragon.
Jesus Dragon.
That's like the idea that everyone's like huddled around me like an orgy.
You sleep pretty peacefully through the night, although, Kathleen, you do tend to wake up every once in a while with a new smell that seems to pass by really close to you, but then goes away, and you feel sort of safe that it's not there anymore. But every once in a while, you feel like something's passing by you, but but nothing's around, you don't notice anything. You also tend to glow like a beacon out in the middle of the night, so good luck staying hidden. Just let you know.
Well, I have the equipment, like sleeping stuff, so I'll just cover myself up like that.
Okay, that'll work. And you wake up in the morning refreshed and raring to go.
Alright, well, you guys ready for this?
Well, I think even if we are ready, we aren't ready. So let's get it over with.
Alright, well, let's try to be stealthy about this and sneak ahead. Ever carefully.
Everyone's gonna have to roll a stealth roll if they're rolling around you.
thought this should be fun.
Do you want me to sneak ahead first, then?
That's the question then becomes, do they want to be in the sand?
Yeah. We have to go together.